Congress approves the Brady bill tonight on Washington Week in Review.
This is Washington Week in Review for Friday, November 26, 1993.
Good evening. It's a joyous Thanksgiving weekend for Sarah and Jim Brady, whose long, hard fight to curb handgun purchases has finally paid off, Congress approving the legislation before quitting for the year, a year that saw at least some of the gridlock begin to ease on Capitol Hill. Well, of course, these closing days were consumed in large measure, Charlie, by the fight over the Brady bill, and after 7 years, that legislation has finally made it.
It had gone on 7 years, and 2.5 of those years recently had been just fighting and Republicans struggling with Democrats, and it had been very tight, and it passed. It's a 5-day waiting period, as I think we all, 5 business days of waiting period if you want to purchase a handgun. And those days are going to be spent checking on who you are and what your record is and all that. It's an interesting start in the gun control world. What's more interesting than that it passed was how it passed, what the context of it was. It was very interesting. The Republicans blocked the bill with a conventional filibuster, as had been their wont, with some Democratic support, by the way, in the Senate. Their phones began to ring. The telegrams began to come. People began to complain. They checked, who are these people? They're our good constituents. The Republicans were behind the curve. 6 senators within 24 hours had gone to Bob Dole and say, we got too far out on this one, we blocked it. My people, it turns out, want it. A lot of people want it. I've always privately wanted it. I was scared to be for it, was a typical Republican reaction. We're talking about a major change, which we ought to talk about some more. These 6 people made it possible for the Senate to vote, pass the thing. 16 Republicans voted for it. Only 8 Democrats voted against it, to give you some idea of the proportion. What the polls were really showing, the Congress had not absorbed, that nearly 90% of Americans wanted to do something, and they outweighed the noted NRA's power. You know, that power had been, the few people at the NRA had been throwing more influence by making more contributions for 20 years. But all of a sudden, something began to change.
But Charlie, doesn't it seem like the National Rifle Association had already conceded some time ago that they had lost this battle and they were focusing on other things? They're already a step ahead of the Congress, trying to head off further incursions on gun owners' rights.
And they probably are. But you were much more alert than the than the people who put on the filibuster in the Senate. They got off on the wrong track. The factors that were at work interest me. Again, I don't think the bill is near as important as what in the heck is going on here. What made people change? Crime. Crime before had meant, well, or allegedly admit, well, I want me a gun to fight criminals with. But we all know. More and more people began to say, there's so much crime going on here, we got to do something about those guns. I mean, there'd been 60% increase in handguns deaths in 5 years. The police of America supported this bill, and they were on television supporting it. The side that defended the bill got them on the air. The waiting period just sort of began to make sense to people. 22 states already have it. It's not as even-handed or strict, but if 22 states are going to try it, it shows people want to try it. And the last thing that I don't know that we don't take for granted too much, Sarah and Jim Brady really captured the imagination of Americans. Not only are they attractive, not only is Jim the wounded man from the attempt to assassinate Reagan, but they are conservative Republicans. And they aren't coming on with some crazy liberal notion. And it drew a lot of people.
There clearly was a change in the politics. It used to be, if you're for gun control, you're considered soft on criminals. Now,
right. Being
for gun control is a sign of toughness, the police being part of it.
Right.
But It seems to me that the Brady bill is only the first of a number of other things coming along. The big crime bill, which is still being discussed, has a provision banning the sale of handguns to minors. 19 assault weapons would be barred from manufacture. When the NRA says this is only the beginning, are they right?
The NRA is telling the absolute truth. This is the beginning after 20 years where the NRA dictated in this field. Now, things are going to begin to happen. Now, they're not going to happen in a storm. If we can keep the youngsters from buying the guns, that's a start. The assault weapons, 19 assault weapons. Well, but they still have to be assault weapons in terms of 10 bullets in a row have to be fired, and there's some exceptions made for hunting guns that fire that much. It's going to be click, click, slow move, but most people that have looked at it see it coming. Let's remember, there's 60 to 70 million handguns out there right now.
So, Charlie,
take years to get them back.
Charlie, are you saying we're going to have a Brady bill every year for the next 10 years to go every next step? And is Mrs. Brady and Jim Brady, are they going to be able to keep their new coalition of supporters together?
I think they will for a while. And I think there will be a proposition before the Congress from now on for a decade anyway, and probably for 3-4 decades as we gradually move. But it will be fairly steady now, I would predict. I think most people would think that.
But in the final analysis, the Brady bill is really perceived, I think, as just a small step in the effort to bring sanity back to the country in terms of
using guns. Small but crucial step, the turnaround.
Right.